This is Javier from ViewSonic, and a lot of teachers have been asking us how can they set up a complete long-term distance learning setup. So I want to show you how I do it, and I hope this is something that's helpful for you. So as you can see in the back, I have my laptop where I have my notes that I'm going to use in the lesson, and then I have a camera where my students can see me and also can hear me because I have a microphone. And on top, I have a large screen which I use a video conferencing tool so I can see all my students, and I can also have a chat box that I can see any questions or feedback from the students. On the side, I have a touch screen which I use my viewboard, whiteboarding, to do an engaging lesson. All right, now I'm gonna show you how to get this hardware set up. Now, first thing I have is my laptop, which is running on Windows 10. And then I have my camera with my microphone. So in this case, it uses a USB connection. So I'm gonna get this USB cord and connect it to my laptop. Now, secondly, I wanna connect this large display to my laptop. First, I wanna make sure the power's on and it's connected. In this case, this uses an HDMI, so I'm gonna get this HDMI cord and connect this display to my laptop. Great. Now, third is actually connecting my touch display. Now again, I wanna make sure that the power's on and power's connected, so I wanna connect this display through an USB-C to my laptop. So I'm connected right here. All right. Now that I have all my displays connected, I'm gonna do some simple settings. All right, let's go over some settings right now. So first thing I'm gonna do is on my desktop, I'm gonna right click and go to display settings. Now the first thing I wanna do is make sure that all my displays are extended. So here I scroll down to multiple display and it says multiple displays. I choose extend desktop to this display. Second thing I want to do is I want to make sure the resolution. So first thing I want to check the resolution for my laptop, and I make sure it's recommended at 1920 and 1080. That's perfect. So then I look at my touch screen and see set up exactly the same. So 1920 times 1080. That's perfect. And third thing I want to set up is the spacing. So in this case, since I have my large display on the top, so I want to make sure that I leave it on the top. A quick way is to just click on identify so I can see which screen is where and set up accordingly how I want it set up. Once I'm done with that, I just click on apply and we're set up. The second thing I want to set up is I want to identify which screen is going to be the touch screen. So a very easy way to do that is go to my finder or search. In the search box, just type in control panel and I open control panel. Now I have all these different icons. I want to look for one that says tablet PC settings. I click on tablet PC settings. I choose on display option, choose which one is my touch display. So in this case, it's my TD24555. And then I go to setup. Now you see all your screens turn to white. And right now it's in my desk, in my laptop. In my laptop, this is not my touch screen. So I just click enter and move on to the next one. My large display is not my touch screen. So I click enter and move on. And my touch screen, I use my pen, I tap on it, click enter, and I'm set. Perfect. So now that I have all my screens synced and set up, extended how I wanted, I want to put all my apps where they belong. So in this case, I'm going to open my viewboard, my digital whiteboard, and I'm going to drag it to my touchscreen. I want to open my virtual conference tool, and I want to move my video conference tool to the top screen. And then I'm gonna open my notes in my laptop and I'm ready to start a class.